This week on BGTV, we're going to talk about the young poets emerging from Washingtonville High School with Amanda Murphy.
Show our support to senior football player Colin Dorothy on Training with Tripp. Gianna Archibald will share her PSA on scholarships.
Rebecca Bucks will be covering Michael Foley and his dad on their woodworking business. And lastly, what you've all been waiting for, Showbiz with Sean. And this week, it's Footloose.
And that's all coming up on BGTV.
Nation, I'm Sarah.
And I'm Gabby.
And you're watching
BGTV.
Football is back. Anyone interested in playing JV or varsity football, there will be a mandatory informational meeting Thursday, February 4th at 7 p.m. See Coach Finocchio or Coach Delgado for the Google Meet link.
The spring esports season is just around the corner. Wizards Esports competes against other high schools across New York and the Eastern region. This season, we are excited to announce the addition of Madden 21, FIFA, and Fortnite Trios. They are also accepting registrations for our established teams in League of Legends, Overwatch, and Rocket League. Limited positions are available. Tryouts will be held remotely in the second week of February. Please contact Mr. Cauldron to sign up in advance or to get more information.
Attention students, just a reminder, all school meals, breakfast, and lunch will be served free of charge until the end of the year. This is only for meals and does not include a la carte or snacks. Young poets are emerging from Room 140 in Washingtonville High School.
Mr. Reamer has started a new poetry project with his students that has caught the attention of the entire district.
Here's Amanda Murphy with more details.
Hey Wizards, this is Amanda Murphy from BGTV, and this week we're going to take a look at Mr. Reamer's English students and their exciting poetry projects.
I'm here with 10th grade English teacher, Mr. Reamer. And Mr. Reamer, what made you decide you wanted your students to partake in this project?
So I was thinking about last spring when we were all in quarantine and how suddenly like a really busy life became a very boring life with nothing to do. And I realized as I was doing nothing and students were doing nothing that it became harder to kind of define yourself. So I started thinking over that summer, what could I do that would not only give us a lot of work and keep us really busy, but also help us redefine ourselves and re-get to know ourselves in the process after such a weird year. Yeah, James. All right, cool. So we have your explanation about what different parts of this tanka mean.
A key part of the creative process, no matter what the art you're creating, is sharing. We don't create art just to keep it to ourselves. So I always knew that by the time the students had written out their entire poetry anthology, it was going to be necessary to publish it so other people could enjoy it. What they'll do is after they've written their own personal collections of poetry, they'll receive a published booklet of that for themselves to keep, and they'll be able to contribute as many poems as they want to the 10th grade wide anthology. And that will be placed here in the school library. We're going to work on getting it placed at the Moffitt Library as well, and we'll also publish a video recording of a sort of like a poetry recital to the website. And then the very end of the project is going to involve students actually choosing if they'd like to send their poems out to different literary magazines and websites to try to get them published outside of the school environment as well.
So I'm here with Danielle, and what did you decide to write your poem about?
I decided to write about tattoo culture.
Are you excited for it to be published?
Yeah, I think it would be pretty cool for people to read my work and stuff.
And do you think that writing these poems has made you a stronger writer?
Yeah, I definitely enjoy writing poems. I'm not much of a big story writer, so I definitely enjoy writing shorter things.
So what did you write your poem about?
I wrote about art culture.
And are you excited for your poem to be published?
Yeah, I'm excited for my poem to be published. I think that'll be pretty cool.
Do you think that writing these poems has made you a stronger writer?
I think so. You know, going through the year, I think as we do more stuff like this, because I never really wrote a poem before, I think doing more of them will make me learn a little bit more.
It's amazing to see all these great poets in our very own school. I can't wait to see what you guys publish.
Great work is also being done by senior football player Colin Dorothy.
Here's Angelica Tripidianos on Training with Tripp featuring Colin Dorothy.
Hey Wizard Nation, my name's Angelica Tripidianos, your sportscaster for BGTV.
With high-risk sports coming up, we're going to talk to a local trainer to see how he has been helping athletes enhance their skills. With senior football player Colin Dorothy to talk to him more about how he's been training for the upcoming season. So Colin, why did you start training with Coach Crown?
I started training with Coach Crown because I heard really good stuff about him. I heard he does weightlifting, speed, and agility, and I'm trying to be a better player for my senior year.
Since the pandemic hit, what have you been doing to prepare for the football season?
I've been going to the gym, lifting a lot. I've also been going to the field with a few of my teammates, of course, who wear masks to stay safe. And I also go to a few trainers to help work up my agility and speed.
Are you excited for football to start on March 1st?
Yeah, of course I am. I was really upset that we could have possibly not have had a season. But I'm really glad that we're finally getting a 6-game season in before we graduate.
So, Colin, what are your future plans?
My future plans is I'm attending Old Dominion University down in Norfolk, Virginia in the fall. I'm planning on walking on to the football team, and I'm also majoring in political science.
So, today I'm here with Coach Crown to learn more about him as a trainer. So, Coach Crown, have you seen an increase of athletes wanting to train with you since the pandemic hit?
We have. We have been an outlet for people to have an opportunity to train from the beginning of the pandemic until now. And mainly what we've done is we started with the protocols, you know, so it was the social distancing, the masks, sanitizing everything, and going into public places, public spaces outside, just to get the activity.
What school districts train with you?
We are at 26 in Section 9, from Onteora to Port Jervis. And then we also have quite a few from Rockland and, of course, Don Bosco. Local area is the strongest. Would love to have more Washingtonville.
How long have you been coaching and training athletes?
Well, I've been coaching high school athletes and collegiate athletes for about 11 years. And that's primarily all I train, off season, through during the season.
How important do you think training is to the mental health of athletes?
Oh, it's huge. I mean, you know, when we were through COVID, so many of us couldn't have the activity, couldn't have the interaction with other athletes. And mentally, we all know how we felt, right? I mean, you feel stagnant, you know? And when bad things happen, you know, it expanded. It became more. So, I mean, working out, you feel better about yourself.
It is so awesome to see Coach Crown and Colin Dorothy working together. I can't wait to see what March 1st brings for high-risk sports. This is Angelica Tripodianos, your sportscaster from BGTV.
Are you a senior? If so, it's time to start applying for scholarships.
Here's how you can start using Naviance.
Go to Naviance and click on the Colleges tab, then go to Scholarships and Money.
Once you do a national scholarship search, you'll be matched to tons of scholarships.
Let's get some advice from school faculty. Come on!
Apply to everything. Always apply more because you're not going to get all of them. But any scholarship you can apply for, even if it's $500, $200, apply to all of them.
So I do have some tips for our seniors. The first and most important thing is I want every senior at least once a week to be checking your Naviance page under colleges, right-hand side scholarship list. Any local scholarships we get are gonna be posted there and they come and go, so check once a week. I also want you to talk to your parents. Parents through their employers may have some scholarship opportunities through their employers as well. Also, and lastly, on our website, we have some links to other scholarship resources, national search engines, as well as through the state of New York. As always, if you have questions, please come down and see your school guidance counselor. We're glad to help where we can.
Seniors, this is an important step in the college planning process. Apply for scholarships now to save yourself later.
This was a PSA with Gianna, and I'll see you next week, Wizards.
You know, Sarah, there are a lot of hardworking and inspirational parents at Washingtonville High School.
Yeah, Mr. Foley and his son, Michael, are working together to help grow their woodworking business.
Let's check it out.
With many new small businesses coming out of the pandemic, being successful is a huge goal. But being successful starts with doing what you love with the people you love.
I'm Michael Foley Sr., and I'm the owner of Blue Line Woodworks.
And I'm Michael Foley Jr., and I am the apprentice slash son.
I started woodworking when back in high school with my wood shop. Actually, the reason why I took wood shop is because my football coach was my wood shop teacher. And I did wood shop, I think, 3 out of the 4 years. And then I was always working with my hands. I always worked with my grandfather. My grandfather always, I was always doing stuff with my grandfather. He was in construction. And then my parents, they always did everything in the house themselves. So we always did everything as a family, working outside, working inside the house, working with my grandfather. I worked with my grandfather since I was, able to walk. I would go and work with him on constructions on sites. And then as I got older, he would teach me how to use the tools. And I've just been doing it ever since. I didn't make a career out of it. I just did it on the side. And then now since I recently retired, and now I do it full time.
I like working with my dad. Yes. I learned a lot of things. I love him. He's my dad. So obviously I want to help him. It's just fun. It's fun learning how to use wood, changing wood into something completely different and making use out of it.
Early 2020, we actually started the business. And in late 2020, it was full swing. And then up until today. So when I first started off, I would build things and just give them to family and friends. I didn't really start selling stuff until probably mid last year. Actually, my three partners from work turned around and said, "You're crazy. You keep giving this stuff away. It's too good." So that's when I started selling stuff. Was probably mid last year. He's been with me. I mean, he hasn't left my side since he's able to walk. He would go everywhere with me. He's always outside with me. He's always doing stuff with me as far as either working around the house, working in the shop.
The favorite thing I've ever done with my father was molding and redoing the crown molding on our living room, repainting it and making it look really nice. So since my dad has retired, which he really excelled in over the years, he was very hardworking. He still very much is, always taking late night shifts so that we always had somewhere to live. So even after he retired, he still works constantly around the house, always trying to upgrade the house in anything he does, try to get side jobs so we can get things that we want. I'm proud of him.
For anyone looking to buy some products, here's his Instagram. This is Rebecca Buxton signing off for BGTV.
That is so cute. They have a great bond.
Yeah. Keep up the great work, you two. Sarah, you know, I've had this song stuck in my head all day because of Sean Beck.
What song?
Now you gotta cut loose. Footloose. Kick off your Sunday shoes.
Hey, this is a dance-free school. This is so boring. We need a revolution. Let's dance.
Show him back to the principal's office now.
That's it this week, Wizards.
Don't forget to check out our weekly newsletter and podcast.
See you next week on BGTV.